Hello everyone. This group represents the health promotion model of Nola Pendo. My name is Mirovi. The other three members of this group are Sue, Yin, and Leah. We are going to talk about the American Cancer Society ACS guideline for healthy lifestyle changes to prevent cancers. According to ACS, about 20% of all cancer diagnosed in the US are related to body fatness, physical inactivity, excess alcohol consumption, and or poor nutrition. Over 1.5 million people in the US will be newly diagnosed with cancer by 2019, and over 500,000 deaths related to cancer will occur in the same year. This is according to Siegel, Miller, and Jamal from the report on cancer statistics done in 2019. Poor nutrition and lack or decrease in physical activity represent 1/3 of cancer, leading to overweight or obese people. And this is from the ACS guideline published in 2012. Also, on the revised ACS guideline made in 2017, it is estimated that 2 out of 3 Americans are overweight or obese, and about 20% of all cancer diagnosed in the U.S. are related to lifestyle choices that help prevent the diagnosis in the first place, which is why I will discuss about the clinical practice guideline description of the American Cancer Society guideline on nutrition and physical activity for cancer prevention, reducing the risk of cancer with healthy food choices and physical activity. This guideline was funded and published by the ACS in January 2012. However, endorsement is not applicable to this guideline. The last revision was in April 2017. As a matter of fact, the guideline is published approximately every five years and is developed by a national panel of experts in cancer research and prevention, epidemiology, public health and policy, and it reflects the most current scientific evidence related to dietary and activity pattern in cancer risk. It's also important to note that the guideline is consistent with guidelines from the American Heart Association and the American Diabetes Association. The overall objective of the ACS guideline is to serve as a foundation for reducing cancer risk by providing recommendations for an adequate dietary and physical activity pattern for Americans to follow. The American Cancer Society 2010 Nutrition and Physical Activity Guideline Advisory Committee wrote this guideline. The guideline is meant to target adult, adolescent, and children in the U.S. treated in primary care setting to reduce cancer risk. Infant and neonate were excluded. The best way to understand how this guideline can help our population is by knowing how it was created. So let's discuss about the method used to develop the clinical practice guideline.
Now, I'm going to talk about study methods used to develop the clinical practice guideline. This guideline is composed of randomized control trial, prospective core study, and population-based case control study. PubMed, which is an electronic database, was used to collect data. Expert consensus was used to assess the quality and strength of the evidence, as well as to formulate the recommendation. Review of published meta-analysis was used to evaluate the evidence, and internal peer review was used to validate the guideline. Now, let's talk about inclusion and exclusion criteria during the development of ACS guideline. In this guideline, in order to evaluate the evidence from randomized control trial, the committee examined the design of the studies and their findings, making sure that their questions are being addressed, and whether or not the feature was meaningful. In addition, population-based case control studies with at least 200 cases of cancers were considered more informative than smaller or hospital-based case control studies. However, prospective core studies provided more in-depth information than those from the case control study, especially when the literature was available from several cohorts. It is also important to mention that studies taking into consideration modifiable risk factors such as food intake were more credible than the rest, which means that studies with non-modifiable risk factors such as genetic, environmental, and virus were part of the exclusion criteria. Unfortunately, there was no rating system provided for the evidence or recommendations.
Now let's talk about the clinical practice guidelines recommendations for cancer prevention. The first one is weight control. The goal here is to achieve and maintain a healthy weight throughout life. Body mass index helps determine if an individual has a healthy weight. Experts consider a BMI between 18.5 to 25 to be healthy. A number below that would be considered underweight, while above 25 would be considered overweight. These numbers are calculated by using your weight and height. In general, the higher the number, the more body fat a person has. However, a normal BMI does not always equal healthy, because this number does not differentiate between fat or muscle mass. The goal is to be as lean as possible throughout life without being underweight, and also avoiding excess weight gain at all ages. For those who are currently overweight or obese, losing even a small amount of weight has health benefits and is a good place to start. Key strategies for maintaining a healthy weight are through physical exercise and nutrition. Now let's talk about the second recommendation, which is to adopt a physically active lifestyle. According to the new ACS guideline, adults should engage in at least 150 minutes of moderate intensity or 75 minutes of vigorous intensity activity each week, or an equivalent combination, preferably spread throughout the week. However, a moderate intensity activity for someone might be vigorous for another. To find examples of these exercises, you can refer to the ACS website and consult with your own healthcare provider. Children and adolescents should engage in at least 1 hour of moderate or vigorous intensity activity each day, with vigorous intensity activity occurring at least 3 days each week. Limit sedentary behaviors such as sitting, laying down, watching TV, or other forms of screen-based entertainment. Doing some physical activity above usual activities, no matter what one's level activity, can have many health benefits. A combination of physical activity and a nutritious diet are fundamental to our overall health, which brings us to the third major recommendation, which is the consumption of a healthy diet. Choose foods and beverages in amount that help achieve and maintain a healthy weight. Eat at least 2.5 cups of vegetables and fruits each day. Choose whole grains instead of refined grains products. If you drink alcohol, limit the consumption. Drink no more than 1 drink per day if you're a woman, or 2 per day if you're a man. Part of the new changes on the ACS guideline from 2012 to 2017 were 1. Children, teens, and pregnant women, or people with a family history of alcoholism, or even those taking prescription or over-the-counter medicines that interact with alcohol should not drink alcohol at all. And the second is to limit the consumption of processed meat and red meat, such as beef, pork, and lamb. Instead of red meat, choose fish, poultry, or beans. Prepare it by baking, broiling, or pouching rather than by frying. As Sue mentioned previously, the authors did not provide any strength rating for these recommendations.
In conclusion, being overweight and obese are two main factors for the increasing rates of cancer morbidity and mortality. The ACS guidelines to reduce cancer risk focuses on maintaining a normal BMI through a healthy diet and physical activity. To facilitate these lifestyle changes, it is important that the public, private, and community organizations work in conjunction in developing policy and environmental changes. For instance, increasing food and drink choices that are varied and cost-effective in all settings will help the general population maintain a proper diet as well as having the right proportion and sizing. Physical activity, on the other hand, can be increased through accessible environments such as those for transportation and recreation in the community setting. Although no rating system was provided, these changes can not only be safe and enjoyable, but also foster a healthier lifestyle that most individuals can adopt and maintain. The ACS claims that most children and young adults can safely perform moderate to vigorous activities without checking with their doctors. However, consultation with healthcare provider is advised for middle-aged men age 40 years and older and women age 50 years and older when implementing lifestyle changes, especially those with chronic diseases and cardiovascular risk factors. Overall, as a group, we do recommend the ACS guideline on nutrition and physical activity for the target population, which are children, adolescents, and adults in primary settings. We recommend this guideline because it is consistent with other guidelines such as the American Heart Association and the American Diabetes Association. Also, a review of published meta-analysis were used to analyze the evidence, which is one of the highest level of evidence. However, we found some flaws while evaluating the ACS guidelines. Some of them are due to the absence of a rating system for the evidence and recommendation, as well as endorsement from any other organization. Details for inclusion and exclusion criteria, for instance, the questions that needed to be addressed during data collection were not enlisted, which all in all can pose a risk for bias. we need to make it clear that while we recommend this guideline, we need to emphasize that by following it, it will not prevent anyone from developing cancer. But because the recommendations provided are beneficial to promote healthy lifestyle choices and improve the overall well-being, we believe that the benefits outweigh the risks, which are those for developing cancer and other diseases.